least Cameron's bum had the bottle to sign it. You've done nothing for the people of Wirral. You sit there and think it. Captain Gilchrist talk about rebellion. Can you imagine rebellion from that one? You're not rebelling enough. So, you then come on to how the Tory amendments, which aims to say there's nothing wrong with council finances, everything's rosy despite the massive cuts, which are in figures that are eye-watering to any Labour member, to any Conservative member, to any Democrat member and Green member. These are eye-watering figures that we are being faced with. And to pretend to the people of Wirral that there are no consequences is stupid and wrong. So then we look where the money comes from. Well, the money comes from a non-negotiated settlement with the trade unions. It just says, on budget night, you're losing car allowance and you're losing pay and enhancements from your wages. This is the Jeremy Hunt style of negotiation. So, let's not hear any more of the hypocrisy and nonsense from the Tory benches. I have great faith in Phil, I have absolute faith in you, Christine, working so hard on social services.
Rubbish!
We will get this thing right. This is a budget for the long term and a budget that we will inherit next year. And please, please, don't go back to the old days, Phil. Do not form an alliance with the Conservatives. Because you know what happens then? You get battered.
He's taking the guards off the train, Jim, back in Mersey travel. How safe is that?
Whereby I read the report, I tried to take a hard-nosed
that, but cannot be used for a short period of time, is for those laws are common practice in councils across the country. And what the council members obviously would be entitled to do if we failed to invest that money in short-term investment to other purpose, they'd be able to accuse us of culpable neglect, because by doing that, we're fetching money for this council, which this council would not otherwise have. And it's a cheap approach to try to make something out of that. The very same council's opposite would be really justified if they give a complaint if we didn't do anything with it. But Mr. Mayor, we're not going to take any servants from that side of the house. And here, and it makes my heart to do it, but I can say something about the council greatly at the moment.
No, I'm sure
you I don't always, but I do want something to do it. Mr. Mayor, when they left a £70 million black hole, we asked whether it was gross financial incompetence or scorched earth on the part of a collaboration that knew it could not be re-elected. Now, I give Councillor Blakely credit here, because when I posed that question to him, at our constituency meeting, as many colleagues here will remember, I said, what was it? Was it gross incompetence? Or was it scorched earth? And to his great credit, at that point, Councillor Blakely smiled warmly and nodded his head. So we had the answer.
You always make it for us.
Let's not forget, Mr. Mayor, that they allowed 1,200 plus staff to leave our bank. They borrowed £9 million that has to be repaid over 25 years in order to fund the replacement costs and the redundancy payments and so on. And you know, when they approach this debate in that way and say, what are we doing re-equipping parts of the town hall by putting new desks and that sort of thing in? Well, when you close large parts of your office accommodation and every house is burnt, one of the things you have to do is build in a new floor for them to occupy. And that brings us, of course, to his incredible comment. I didn't think they were going on the Downton Abbey staircase any longer. I thought that would have really run its time. So let me say this to the mayor. If anyone has actually looked at the staircase, I know one of the councillors from that side of Exhale, so I think it was on the show, actually stood next to it for a photograph, so the photograph couldn't actually see the staircase. And they had a note with it saying, Downton Abbey staircase. That staircase was very similar indeed to the bolted steel structure that when I was a younger worker in the blast furnace, which had burned, the same sort of industrial staircase that we had then, Mr. Mayor. But that, of course, was where we had the most modern blast furnaces in the world.
Thank you, Adrian.
Most blast furnaces, which Mrs. Thatcher put down.
We'll restore it.
We sold that steelworks to the Indians who used to buy our steel.
Thank you, Councillor.
Services. Just yesterday, Mr. Mayor, a Guardian investigation showed that
has significantly eroded our tax base. Had we taken a different path, we would not now have to endure the anguish around Girdle Court and the threats to many other vital services. We could have, Mr. Mayor, reversed the unfair imposition of council tax on the very poorest in our borough. Finally, and to conclude, Mr. Mayor, the Green Party opposes the austerity programme imposed by the Conservatives since 2010. We believe that vital public services should be properly funded by ensuring that major corporations pay a fair share of tax, something all political parties should embrace.
People want that choice. Give us figures, please.
Sorry, Council, can you make your comments to me?
That's forgetting for a moment. You were there, Mr. Mayor. You used to do it to me. Mr. Mayor, we do know that if you source services out, often they cost more in the end. That does happen. So that's all I wanted to say, just a personal appeal to you, Christine. You've got a great deal of power here. Well, and take it out of the budget now. Let's put at ease those people who are bitterly and desperately upset about what might possibly be doing. Now, if it won't make any difference, you can still save a bit of money elsewhere. So all I'm saying to you is take it out of the budget now. And lots of people will very much appreciate it.
You're giving us no choice!
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. This Tory government is making very cruel and unfair attacks on areas such as the Wirral, and in particular their decision to remove the local government revenue support grant is saying, as the leader said earlier, to us in the Wirral, you're on your own. Basically saying sink or swim, and I don't know what happened to the phrase "we're all in it together." That's long gone now. With another 28 million savings that we've got to make this year, totaling 126 million by 2020, it would be very easy for the Labour group to stand up, throw our hands in the air, and say we can't do anything. It's all the fault of the national government. But I'm proud, not embarrassed, that under the leadership of Phil Davis, we've got a positive budget before us tonight, which ensures that the vulnerable people in the Wirral are safe and protected, and with inequality being tackled.
I don't think so.
When I see the Tories talk about lollipop ladies, I wonder whether they really understand what equality actually means. What the budget's doing tonight is ensuring that the Wirral is a place where employers will want to invest and businesses thrive. And I've always said, and I've said it before, the Wirral promotes an attractive and sustainable environment, which residents out there have told us is important, including tackling issues like dog fouling, which some people raise as the most important issue time and time again. And I'm delighted, Mr. Mayor, that more than £70 million will be invested into protecting young people. And again, as has been mentioned, the new Wirral Youth Zone, which is being built now as we speak, will be a fantastic, world-class, state-of-the-art facility where all young people in the Wirral will be able to take advantage. And it's an excellent example of partnership working between this council and the private sector. Now, I'm proud, Mr. Mayor, again, not embarrassed, of the progress being made despite the total lack of support from this Tory government. And again, as has already been said, I would appeal even now to every councillor in this chamber, regardless of what party you're from, to support representations to national government to say it's not fair, it's not right, you're singling out areas like Wirral for attention when you look at the money that's being given to other areas in the country who've got a lot more money than us. Totally unfair. So rather than just sit there and meekly support your own government, we are elected by the people of the Wirral to look after the people of the Wirral. So regardless of party, it's not too late. We should all join together, make representation to national government and say, give us a better deal. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Are you proud of closing gifts, or let's look after this table?